The late adopter. Hi guys, how you doing? Welcome back to the channel, to the new video. Right now we're doing Cardano update, and for you guys, this is altcoin channel. We do altcoins here. Thanks for stopping by the way. I see you're interested in what's Cardano doing, so I won't keep you talking long. We're gonna dive into the charts right now and see what's actually happening. Make my face smaller, charts bigger. But before we do that, I just want to thank everybody that subscribed to the channel, because 2 days ago we hit 10k. Thanks for that, and continue doing that, man. 20k, then we get another live stream. That said, let's see what's actually happening with Cardano right now. And we are having this big sell-off, Cardano going to zero kind of move right over here. Panic area. No, not really. This is -5%, but I'm gonna show you that this is perfectly normal move in any kind of uptrend, right? So first thing first, we're gonna pop some lines up here, and for you guys that are new here, then I've been here before, let me explain quickly what's happening. So before, we had something called triangle up here. We are going inside this triangle, and then we broke out of the triangle. And once we broke out of the triangle, we now got this rising wedge. So this rising wedge, we hit it 1, 2, 3 times up there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, a lot of times down there. So we are definitely in a rising wedge. Also very bullish. Now there are two lines. First of all, there are two lines over here, 131 line and 137 line. That's the one over here, one over here. So basically the bottom line, 131, that's the previous close on the daily, and the 137 is also all-time high close on the daily. All-time high local close on the daily. So keep that in mind. Important distinction. That said, we got some kind of high here, higher high, and higher high than previous. So this is uptrend, and they got a low, higher low, higher low. So it's climbing. Climbing up, you can see that by the just looking at the rising wedge, you know. It's a normal pattern. And right now what you can see here, what's happening, once we were down all the way down here at these levels, 120, broke out of the triangle, we started breaking these resistance lines, went all the way up to tested this wedge, and now we are retracing, testing the previous support. So we are testing this support at 137, that's all previously high, and I cannot say 100% sure, but this look like this might hold. If Bitcoin drops like 5% more, it might actually dip like even further. But doesn't matter how long it dips, as long as it doesn't get out of the triangle up here in this area down here, we are all good. If it gets out here, you can start panic, but there is no panic as long as it's keeping inside the rising wedge. So rising wedge is important. That said, right now this move is actually very normal. And what I'm gonna show you now, we're gonna pop some moving averages. So these are moving averages on the price, and this is 10, 20, 50, and 100 moving average. So you can see here that we are way extended from, not way extended, but we are extended from the 10 moving average and 20, right? So some kind of pullback is needed, because once you go that high and then you escape the moving averages, you have to pull a little back and let the moving averages catch up with the price. And you can see this previously here when it was climbing on the moving averages, like it goes up and then it goes to the 10, goes up, goes to 10, goes up, goes all the way down to 10, climbs on 10, up, climbs on 10, and so forth, until it starts breaking it, and we got into this consolidation. But right now we are starting climbing again, so we are probably either going to go sideways and wait for a moving average, or we're going to go all the way down to the moving average and be picked up by the 10 moving average and continue further up. So what are we trying to do is get to this 190 line, right? This line comes from the triangle that we had before, the distance here, the distance there. So that's the target we are trying to hit right now, 190. And that's gonna happen first when we break out of the rising wedge. Once we are out of the rising wedge, we can go all the way to 190, and that's the actual target. But this move down here, it's nothing to be fearful of. That said, let's take a quick look at the indicators and what are they telling us. So right now, this rubber band index, we are now sitting at 60. 60 is a very good number, because you don't want to sit about around like 80, 85 plus 90, these levels up here, because then you hit some kind of tops. But right now there is no top, so there is still more room to grow. We got this bullish cross here on the MACD, that's very nice. And although it is converging, you can see here light green candle down there. It's not candle, light green histogram down there. Usually they go something like this, and then converging, right? They're diverging and then converging. You want to have these lines diverging in the green for price to move up. So right now now they're kind of converging, but that's the normal price, and they want to be, I don't think there will be any bearish cross or something like that. So all good on the technicals, on the daily, on the weekly, also all good, because this rubber band is only sitting on 80, and usually it can go up to 90 plus. Once you get to these 90 plus levels, like over here 94, then you can be kind of worried that something's about to happen, but right now sitting at 82, so no worries at all. And you can see here, although it was converging MACD on the weekly chart, right now it's starting, it's gonna start diverging next week or something like that. Also, a bullish, very bullish thing is that this 10 moving average on the weekly chart, price is actually hitting the 10 moving average, and it's being pushed by the 10 moving average on the weekly chart further up. So all in all, very bullish on Cardano still. This drop here is very welcomed, because we have to get some kind of pullback before we can moon again and get that Lambos, right? And all of this bank. But right now it looks very nice. So if you are in a panic mode or something like that because of minus 5%, like, should you be that? And by the way, is there anything else that's nothing in red? Some coins are not red, some are in red, like, yeah, but I don't know why you're watching Cardano. Maybe you already hodl it, maybe you want to buy it, maybe you don't want to buy it. If you are looking for coins to buy and want to buy, or coins to sell, or what coins are good and bad, we have got this Patreon page where we do like 50 altcoins every single day. We rank them up, look what's good, look what's bad. So if you have a hard time deciding what to buy, what not to buy, maybe that's something to check out. That said, subscribe to the channel, man. 11k subs, man. Thanks for everybody that's subscribed. 11.2 right now. So 11.2. Thanks for subbing, and like the video, because YouTube algorithm helped this small channel up, man. Thanks a bunch. Bye-bye.